Students, then today we'll discuss about the energy. Okay, and whenever we talk about the energy, before starting the energy, let us remind our previous class. We have discussed that to perform a work, what is the requirement?
Force.
First of all, there should be the displacement. Okay. And to displace a body, some force is required.
Yes, sir.
If you will apply the force, then definitely there is a chance of displacement. Okay?
Yes,
because without any force, no displacement will be there. No? Then we have discussed that if you want to perform the work, then there should be displacement and by the application of some force. And we have also written the formula, work is equal to force in the direction of displacement, force into displacement in the direction of force. Students, today we are talking about the energy. Students, suppose whenever there is a work done, then a force is required. No? And to apply that force, some agency is needed, some source is needed. If you want to shift a table from one place to another place, means if you want to perform a work, then there is a need of force. Who will apply the force? Someone will apply the force. It means that boy is the source of that force. Okay? Suppose you, if you not have the food from last 3-4 days, okay? And now, is it possible that comfortably you can move that table?
No, sir.
Because now you, I will say, now I have no energy to do that task. Similarly, suppose I have a big block of stone, okay? And I want to move that stone from one place to another. For that, I have a crane. That crane will perform that task, okay? That crane will apply the force to move that stone. But suppose if there is no diesel or petrol in that crane, now is it able to perform that task or not? No. Wo crane us stone ko abhi shift nahi kar payega. Karna usi ko hai, but that crane has no energy. Ab bologe na? It means energy is something, I repeat again, energy is something which makes a body capable to do work. Energy कुछ ऐसी चीज है जिसकी वजह से वो body work करने के capable होता है. Suppose if you have a bike but there is no petrol, it means that petrol make capable that bike to for motion. Similarly, if we have a fan but no electricity, it means that electricity is something which is making that fan capable to rotate. Then in different ways we can see, if we want to perform a task, if we want to perform a work, then there should be a source which make us or make that body to perform that task. And that thing is called energy. It means energy defines the capability of a body to do work. More energy, more capable that body. Suppose if in a bike there is a 1 liter of petrol, it will move 40 to 50 kilometers. But suppose there is a bike that has 10 liter of petrol, now it can move 400 to 500 kilometers. No? It means more energy, more capable the body is. That's why we say energy is the capability of a body to do the work. Without energy, we cannot do the work. Khana nahi khaya, 2-3 din se, body mein koi energy nahi hai. Toh bologe, nahi, aaj khana nahi khaya, koi energy nahi hai. Then, energy is the capability of a body to do work. Now, students, we will define the energy, we will classify the energy in two parts. One is kinetic energy and another is potential energy. Energy will be classified into two parts, kinetic energy and potential. Kinetic. Students always remember the meaning of that term. Then definitely you will be able to understand maximum part of that topic. Kinetic means motion. When the term kinetic arises, then kinetic means motion. Kinetic energy. Energy possessed inside a body due to its motion. If a body has a motion and due to that motion the body has energy, that energy is called kinetic energy. Suppose if you throw a stone, then that stone has a such amount of energy that it can break this glass. No? Suppose if you have fired a bullet, then that bullet is a such amount of energy that bullet can penetrate the body, make a hole inside the body. A moving wind, it has energy or not?
Yes.
It can rotate a fan. No? It can rotate a windmill. Suppose a flowing water, it has energy due to its motion. No? Then similarly, energy possessed inside a body due to its motion is called kinetic energy. And whenever there is a motion, definitely there will be a kinetic energy. If I drop this chalk, if I drop this duster, then you can see this duster has energy. And if I place this chalk below this duster, then this duster will break this chalk. No? It means this moving duster has energy. Then energy possessed by a body due to its motion is called kinetic energy. Kinetic means motion, and the energy due to the motion is called kinetic energy. The second type of the energy is called potential energy. When you talk about the potential energy, potential means something is stored. Sometimes teacher says, that boy has a very high potential. Definitely he will do very good in his future. Then potential means that boy has something inside him which is hidden, some intelligence is there. Okay. Then potential is a term which is used for the storage of something like energy, something which is invisible but that can be stored. Suppose I am talking about here potential energy. Then we will say energy possessed inside a body or energy is stored inside a body. How? Due to its specific position or its specific shape. I repeat again, potential energy means stored energy. And how that energy will be stored? By changing its shape or position. Suppose I have a rubber band and I stretch that rubber band, then I am just keeping it in the stretched condition. Now this rubber is looking stationary, but if I will release it towards someone, it will release its energy. Sabne apne friends ko aise rubber kheench ke mara hoga. Nahi mara. Then you can see when we stress that, then there is a change in its shape. And due to change in its shape, some energy has stored there. Now, a loaded gun. If you have a loaded gun and if you put it someplace, then from outside that is in the rest position, that is stationary. But if someone fire that, then it releases the energy. It means that gun has stored some energy. A stressed spring. Suppose you have stressed a spring. Then this stressed spring is looking at the rest, but if we release this spring, it will start to compress and expand. No? Then you can see there was energy. Suppose if I raise this duster up to a certain height, if I raise this duster to a certain height, is there any energy inside this duster? Is there any energy inside this duster?
Yes, sir.
No.
Yes.
Or yes?
Yes.
How?
Yes.
If I release this duster, you can see It has energy. Because due to this energy, this duster has started to move. मैंने इसको पुश नहीं किया चलने के लिए, खुद से चलने लगा. It means this duster has energy. Now, similarly, if there is a stored water in a dam, if we have a stored a water inside a dam, then what happens? That water has a huge amount of energy. That water is looking in rest, but that water has a huge amount of energy. If you open the gate of that dam, that water starts to move with a high velocity. Okay, and we can use that water for a generation of electricity. Then, whenever we talk about the potential energy, then there is energy stored inside a body due to its specific shape or due to its specific position. Okay, and students, we can see when we are stretching the rubber, there is a change in its shape. Now, when I am raising this duster, then there is change in its position. Means if you want to store the energy, you have to do something by which we can change the shape or we can change its position, and due to that change, the body will store the energy. Very simple example, if you have a cup of water, what happens? If you have a cup of water, if you place it on the table, then from outside it looks very cold, no? But if someone applies a matchstick, then what happens? It will start to burn. It means that cup of petrol has a stored energy. Then energy stored by a body is called potential energy, and energy possessed it due to its motion is called kinetic energy. Okay. One more thing, whenever we talk about these two types of energy, again we can classify according to their states. Like the electrical energy, if you have a cell or battery, then the cell or battery has which type of energy? Potential or kinetic?
Kinetic.
Potential. If you place a charged cell or battery, suppose if you have a cell and if you placed it here, it's very simply, it's looking very rest way. You can say it's there is no motion, there is nothing. But if you place it inside a toy car, then what happens? That car starts to move. If you place it inside the dancing monkey, the monkey starts to dance. No? Yes, yes, like that. Then what happens? There is a stored energy. Due to that, that toy has to start some motion. Similarly, if you have a hot water, a bottle of hot water, it has a kinetic energy or potential energy?
Potential energy.
Potential energy. No? Because it had stored energy in the form of heat. No? Then in different ways we can store the energy. Okay. Then now we will write the definition, okay, and their classification.